Boys, wife, boy, my another is my radio. What's going on? To hit me up or to chit chat a little bit, hit me up on my social media. On Instagram, I'm under Bertel Smalls. On Snapchat, which is my favorite, I'm under Suave Boom. And if you want to see a behind the scenes type of stuff, go hit up our vlog channel, Love at First Bite Vlog. I'm sorry, my mouth is watering. Strizz up. I'm going to leave all my social media information down in the description box below. That being said, let's get into it. First and foremost, before I do get into it, I wanted to shout out Sass ASMR. This is a remake of her. I think it's like a rotisserie. I don't even remember. I should have done my research before I actually got into this. But this is a remake of her rotisserie chicken lettuce wrap thing. I don't know, it was like a chicken, it was the lettuce wraps, a sweet Thai chili sauce, and some kimchi, so it looked really bomb. I'm on my sexy, you know what I'm saying, I'm on my sexy diet right now. I don't know what I'm gonna say about that. Yeah, I'm trying to eat a little bit better, so I figured I'd buy some of this, because it looked bomb in the video, and it looks really bomb here too, so let's do this. She do it. You know what? Oh my Gouda. You know what? I got my fancy schmancy LaCroix. This is Pepino and Blackberry. Exactly what you think it would be. Lettuce and some spicy ass cabbage. This isn't really spicy. I'm sorry, guys. Let me stop being so negative. It's just, I'm trying to get my sexy back. And this eating healthy stuff is just not, it's not going very well. I mean, I know this stuff is good. I'm just trying to get over. Oh, here we go. There we go. Let's get a nice one here. This is real life, guys. This is real life. Sometimes you just gotta chicken wing it. You know what though? Before, if you can't find Sass ASMR, I'm sure you'll be able to go to my liked videos, and the particular video I'm remaking, it's in there. Real talk, this video isn't gonna be even close to being as good as hers, so I'm just giving you a heads up. ASMR channel recently, and that's a cool one. Recently came out with a video talking about a particular subject, which kind of sparked some interest into a conversation. that Abby and I got into. And I don't think it's fair if I sat here and told you guys, you know, this particular person's name or any of their business, whatever. I mean, obviously they put themselves out there on YouTube and they talked about their particular issue, but that's on them. So I just want to kind of, anyways, this particular person talked about, you know, talked about their particular emotional issues and things that they have to deal with their personality, and they were talking about how they act in relationships and how how they're very possessive and jealous and manipulative and abusive, and she was saying relationship she was in, she was very insecure of herself and very negative and possessive, jealous, all the things I said, you know. And by all means, I'm only the examples I'm gonna give you guys. I can only speak for myself. I can't speak. I mean, there's plenty of men that are like that too. Excuse me. But I don't want this to turn into a conversation of you thinking I'm sitting here shaming only women, because men are like this too, for real. But I guess I just wanted to say that all my life, whether it was women I dated myself or a homegirl or like a friend of mine that has also acted like this, whatever. But one of the things that every woman, in my opinion, has shared in common, they'll go on a huge rant about how they're this, they're that, they're this, they're just not good for dating right now or seeing anybody or whatever. And I really do think it's healthy to say what I'm about to say or do what I say to do. A year. See if you can do that. Like, if you're in medicine because there was a situation in my life where I was making a lot of bad decisions, doing a lot of wrong things in life, and let me know in the comments if I'm just bullshitting, if I'm just crazy. If you don't agree with that advice, let me know. Like, I'm open to hear something different. Like, I just don't feel like it's very healthy for, like, if you're going on long-ass rants about your this, that, and you're really upset with yourself, and you're this thing that you don't want to be, it's not fair to be that in front of other people, whether it's somebody you want to date, whether it's somebody you like, whether it's a friend, whether it's friends with benefits, whether it's anybody, co-workers, whatever. Be a secluded person for a while and work on you for real, like wholeheartedly, like for real by yourself. None of this loophole shit where you're hanging out with a guy, he's just my friend, blah, blah, blah. No, you need to be around, like, yourself, and that's it, and do you. I feel like that's really good advice. It's worked for me. It's worked for a few other, the few amount of friends that they've actually taken that type of advice. He's gonna change me. He's gonna turn me into this other person. Nah, don't depend on that. Don't depend on, because honestly, I don't want you. And no man wants that. You think guys are walking around like, man, I can't wait to find that one really fucked up chick that I can change and mold into something. No, no. It's more rewarding when you can do that yourself and then find someone. And honestly, people are attracted to happy people. Attracted to positive, like, there's nothing more attractive than meeting a woman that makes me feel like she don't want me, that makes me feel like she don't need me whatsoever. Somebody I can look at and be like, damn, like, that they got their shit together, and I gotta work for her because she really doesn't want me. And that type of shit, like, something like that really means a lot. I don't know. Give me your opinions down below. Let me know what you think. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for having lunch with me. Thumbs up the video if you like it. Thumbs down if you don't. Comment, subscribe, and we'll see y'all on the next video. Alright, y'all.